It's 104.5, man, and it's a beautiful situation. I have none other than the queen of the Carolinas right now,
first lady,
one of the first lady of the Carolinas. I got Big Mally. But before we even get into the interview, I gotta say happy birthday to you. Can you celebrate the birthday?
Thank you, D Daddy. Thank you so much. Yes, it's my birthday. Period. I just turned 19.
Oh,
I'm in Miami with it.
Oh so. Man! Now you, the world has waited. The Carolinas has waited for Gangsta Talk. And you came through with Gangsta Talk, which came out Friday, which dropped. Mm-hmm. That's got to be the greatest birthday gift ever. The whole world going crazy about Gangsta Talk. How you feel right now? How you feeling?
I feel good because it's like they've been waiting so long. And it's like, I know my fans was probably thinking like, damn, like when she do drop some shit, man, that shit ain't even gonna be what we was waiting for. But when I dropped, they was going crazy. If it's a good feeling, it's good to see everybody supporting me. Not even just Carolina. I'm getting love from everywhere, like a national, like from the whole wide world. So I feel real good. I feel great. And it's my birthday, like you just said, so I'm pretty lit. It was a good present to myself and to the fans, to the people.
So the last time that you chopped it up with me, you pulled up on me, it was way before coronavirus, right before the pandemic.
What has
Big Mally been doing during the... Now, I had the opportunity to see you perform at Raleigh Day. I saw you perform at Raleigh Day. And was that your first performance of 2020? Because I'm sure that this year we haven't been able to perform and do what we normally do.
Nah, I had another booking in Baltimore since the virus and everything. And I ain't gonna lie, like, that performance compared to Raleigh Day, it was way like more lit, more people, you know, more even like it really like the virus really ain't stopped nothing. That's how I'll be looking at it. Cause you know, I just did another show. I don't know if you knew about it, the one in Charlotte, the Out of the Mud.
Yeah,
I just did that show too, and that one was pretty lit too. So it don't look like everybody really coming back. It don't look like it's pretty much stopping nothing.
The album Gangsta Talk, I previewed it. I listened to it all the way through. And I got two personal favorites on that album.
What's your favorite? Because I know we got the same favorite.
Yeah, one of them is Win. I love Win. Okay. I love Win because you're shining light on a social injustice time. And you speaking to the culture on that. And then the other one is the one you got with Asian. The one you got with, it's different. It's super duper fire. That's me. I think that's
like the biggest record because everybody, did you see the video too?
Yeah, the video.
Yeah, so the video and like when we dropped the video, the snippet, not even the video, when we did the teaser, it was like a test, you know, to see like how bad they wanted. And then when we seen it, it was just going viral, it was going crazy on Twitter. We was just like, man, we got to drop that. Like, she said, fuck it, let's just drop it when you drop your album. So I was like, hey, let's do it. And then I had dropped the album at 12 o'clock, 12 a.m., you know, 12 a.m. Friday. So Thursday night, but Friday morning. And then we had dropped the video 10 a.m. that same Friday. So, and when we got up, it was just crazy. It was going crazy. That's my favorite song. I like that song too because the beat and everything, that's produced by Soul Got Hits too. Yeah. A lot of people, he's from South Carolina. He do a lot of beats for like Black Zach,
You work with Zach on this tape, and you work with DaBaby. You work with some of your label. Now you the first lady of the label. You're the first lady of the label. How does it feel to be the only girl on the label?
Well, it feel good, but I mean, I'm the first lady, so I ain't gonna just say I'm the only girl. We just did recently sign another girl.
Tia Corrine.
We just recently signed. She's from Winston, I think. Yeah. North Carolina. She pretty hard too. But as far as me, but feeling of being the first lady, it's no better feeling because it's like I get a lot of respect from my label mates. Not just that, I get a lot of respect from the CEO. Everybody love me, show me a lot of love. I don't get into it with nobody, you know. It feel good. And then it's like to see all my label mates supporting my project, even the ones that wasn't on there, you know, like 2C and a lot of other people that just wasn't a part of the project, but still seeing their support, feel really good. Because I don't know, like being the first lady, it's like you got a title, you got not a title, but you got something to, you know, prove. But it's like, I feel like I've already proven it. So it's like, now it's just stamped. Like, I'm the first lady and like, everybody know, like, you feel me?
Now you stand out. You stand out along with your rapid flow. Mm-hmm. And I had to ask, have you ever got in the lab and tripped up over somewhere? Cause you be going, you be flowing.
Hell yeah. It happened to everybody, bro. Hell yeah. Everybody say that too. They be thinking I be going there just like straight through. Like, nah. I really be punching in, but it's like I be catching the beat, I be catching the bar so quick, motherfuckers just be like, yo, damn, like I don't know how the fuck she just put that in there like that. But I be tripping up a couple times, tongue twisting, all that. Like, I ain't really mean to say everything.
Now, I think the last time we talked about short term and long term goals, and you've accomplished a lot since the last time we're a lot. Yeah. The world, people don't realize the Carolinas been waiting on gangsta talk for mm-hmm. they've been waiting for Mally to talk that talk. They've been waiting for her to talk that, and you do it with this album. Out of all of the songs on this album, what song did you have the most fun with besides the two that we already mentioned?
456, because I was really lit. Hey, I don't know if you heard that one, but that song and that one doing really good on like TikTok. 456, because it's really like a dancing song. I really made it on some like, you know, you can make a TikTok this, you can get lit to this, like post this, like it's for kids too, like a lot of kids messing with it. Like I had a lot of fun with it because I was really just going like back to back to back, punching in, and it's a little bit slower. So I had a little bit more time to play with it. I ain't get too tongue tied in that one. So I knocked that one out in like 15 minutes. So, you know, I ain't gonna care. I had fun with that record right there. Super duper
amazing. Now you celebrating 19th birthday. 19th birthday. A lot of people didn't know Big Mally celebrating 19.
So young, right? Yeah.
In the game right now, if you could work with anybody that could keep up with your flow, what lady in the game would you want to get on a record with? A female that you would want to go dumb on a record with you.
That I know can keep up with me?
Mm-hmm.
Nikki.
Oh, man. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's only right.
It's simple. Like, she don't even, I mean, respect. I ain't know. You feel me? Like, I ain't going to do that. It's respect. I see a lot of females working. It's a lot of females out here that's getting out the mud, you know, doing what they do, working hard. We coming together right now. We hot right now. Like, you know, you got a lot of girls. You got the City Girls, Mulatto, Doja Cat. You know, everybody working. Like, so it's not even to say like that, but it's just like, you know, like you just said, like a lot of people can't catch the beat. How I can catch the beat. And I ain't saying that they can't, but it's just like, I know for sure Nikki
and I got to say, this. When I first was exposed to your campaign, you was featured on a lot of male artists' records here in the Carolinas, and you was bodying their records. So that alone let you, and shout out to them, but you held your own against in a male-dominated genre. How it feel, man? How it feel? Out 19, how you feeling?
I feel good, because it's like what you just said, a lot of male, it's a male dominant thing. So it's like the fact that you were seeing me mostly on male projects and male records and stuff, that's good, because it's like, dang, like they know, even the dudes know she can keep up. Like, she gonna snap for sure. So I need, you know, like I need Big Mally like on the song. So it feel real good to know that they know just as much as I know that, hey, like, I could come just as hard as you, bro. Like, wow, so it's respect. Like, that just goes right back to the first lady thing. Like, it's just respect. Like, and it feel real good to get that, especially coming from artists coming from the Carolinas trying to do the same thing as me.
Wow. Like, wow. Listen, man, I appreciate you for, because it looked like you celebrate, you on the town, the Miami night.
No, I knew I had to make time for you. I swear to God, I stopped everything just to do this for you, bro. No
doubt. I appreciate that. And we're going to keep supporting the campaign. Everybody make sure that you get that gangster talk. We're going to run that shit up. We need you to get number one on iTunes.
Right now. Right now is the hottest thing out on the street. So I'm telling you, I got everybody talking about me.
Super
them 76 tools gon' fly. Beat 556, we ain't told no lie. That's try me, she got one more time. I'ma spend one time, guarantee she.